this project, my students have figured out a way to use the internal camera in a smartphone as a high-resolution spectrophotometer for performing several of the most important and commonly used tests that are used in biochemistry and molecular biology for detecting toxins, detecting the presence of pathogens, detecting allergens in food, and doing disease diagnostics.
So first off, we're going to select a new experiment. We're then going to essentially take our sample and we're going to put it in the little cartridge position right back here. So here we have a little black bar, and this is essentially a location along the spectrum at which our sensor is resonant at. And depending on where that black bar moves up and down the spectrum, that correlates to a change in color, which is essentially what we're measuring. So we can go ahead and capture our data right now. All right, and so there we have a spectrum right there. But what we're looking for is actually this dip right here in the spectrum. That corresponds to the black gap in the spectrum that you saw on the previous screen. And as that low point moves left and right across the wavelength spectrum, that basically tells us what the shift is in the sensor.
And we're also working in collaboration with Professor Juan Andrade in the Food Science and Human Nutrition Department to develop tests for vitamin A and vitamin D deficiency that can be performed in remote parts of the world on children and pregnant women to help make sure they're getting the nutrition that'll help children develop properly.